Hey, this is Andrew Brown, and in this follow along, let's take a look at object tags. So as per usual, I'm going to get over to my repository, the AWS examples. I'm going to open up a new cloud developer environment, and we're just going to quickly create a bucket, place an object, and apply object tags to it. So it shouldn't be too difficult here. So now that this is launched up, I'm going to create a new folder in here, call this object tags. We'll try this again here, object tags. And I will create myself a readme.md. Okay, and we'll just say create bucket. Upload file. So we go here and we'll say AWS S3, make bucket S3:// object tags fun. AB for my initials, and we'll put some numbers after that. Then we'll go down here below and we'll type in AWS S3 copy, and we'll need some kind of local file. So I'm just going to copy this address here, paste it in, and we'll just say hello.txt as the example. Say echo hello world hello.txt. So we'll go ahead and execute this. So I should have my AWS credentials loaded up here. Yep, that worked out great. So we're gonna touch that file here. Also, just make sure you know where you are. I'm right now in the main root here. So I'm just gonna CD into the object tags directory here. We'll type in clear. We'll go ahead and try this again, paste that in. We'll go ahead and copy this, paste that in. And it doesn't like something here. What did I mess up? AWS S3 CP. Oh, you know, we got to say what file we're copying. So we'll do this. I'll just hit Control C to cancel that out. We'll try this again. We'll hit Enter. And it's going to go ahead and upload that file. So now that file is uploaded. The question is, how do we apply object tags? So we'll go over to the AWS CLI S3 API, because I'm going to assume that the regular one can't do it. And make sure we're on version 2 here. I'm going to search for object tags. So it looks like there is a thing for object tags called put object tagging. We'll go down below and look at the examples. We'll copy this example here. Okay, that one's fine. And then we will go over to here and we'll say apply object tagging. And we will grab the bucket name here. We'll paste it in and we will type in hello.txt. And then we have some tagging. So we have tag sets, and then we have a key and a value. I'm not sure why we have tag sets. I don't know if we talked about that at all. Tag sets, objects, tags in AWS S3. Sometimes you learn about stuff unexpectedly. Tag sets. No, I mean, I guess it's just, it's basically the set of tags. The reason I'm confused is that often when you have other ones, they just will have you pass the key and value right away. But it looks like they're doing it this way. Could we do this in a shorthand? Probably. I don't want to fiddle with it. It seems fine enough. I can go ahead and just say key hello. And then this one is going to be world. And hopefully that will work. We'll go ahead and try this out and hit enter. The reason I say I wonder is because sometimes you have to have prefixes, but that's for metadata, so I guess we're fine here. Let's go take a look at the AWS console. We'll go into S3, and we'll take a look at what's happening here. I got to go log in. Give me just a moment. All right, we're in here, and so we have object tags, and we'll go into this, and we'll see if we can take a look at our object tag. Maybe under permissions, properties. I remember we saw it here before. Oh, here it is, tags. So we have key, hello, value, world. So of course, object tags allows you to do all sorts of interesting automation. We don't really have any use case to intersect any of that right now. So I think what I'm gonna do is just say this is good enough. And if there is an intersection for some other service, like when we do cost management or something, then we will utilize object tags when we can. But for the most part, this is sufficient enough for our learning. We just want to make sure we know how to apply tags and that they're not the same thing as resource tags. So we'll go ahead and just do cleanup here. So there's a couple of things we want to do. AWS S3 remove, and then we'll grab this full address here. And then we wanted to get rid of that bucket. Try this again. There we go. And I'm going to go ahead and copy and paste. And then copy and paste and hit enter. And now we are all good. So I will see you in the next one. Ciao.